a comfort for yourself as a parent to know that when you drop your child off, your child's being well taken care of, your child's teacher's not getting frustrated with them because of the disability that they have. They're working with your child to get over and overcome that.
Yeah, over 400 developmentally delayed kids under 5 years old could be out of their state-funded daycare this Friday after abrupt budget cuts by the Department of Children and Families.
No notice. It was just devastating because these little kids need this program. Our families need these programs. Everybody needs these programs for our society and the future.
That's Diane Katona, whose son Giovanni is 2.5 years old and attends the Ark Mercer's Step Ahead program in Trenton. I went there Thursday morning to get a sense of how the program works and why it works for Giovanni.
We brought him here to this daycare, which is the one who really got him talking and got him doing his manners and sitting still and doing all kinds of fun things. The program is very important because I think the program itself is a big aspect in his life.
You got it! Great job!
Diane and parents like her were given just 10 days notice before the cuts hit and now have to find alternative options for their kids, absent a deal the New Jersey legislature might make as it finishes its budgeting process. The program will be shut down on July 1st and the people who work there out of jobs. Diane will have to find another option for her son by the 4th of July. The Department of Children and Families said they were trying to pivot to home-based solutions for these kids with special needs, but that's not an option for a working mom like Diane.
That's great for the at-home moms, but the ones that actually have to work, and like myself, how am I gonna be home to do at-home services? Who's still gonna watch them during the day? Should I call my boss and say, hey, my son has to come to work with me, and by the way, we have in-home services coming? That doesn't work.
Now, just to be clear, these children are developmentally delayed, they have autism, they have learning disabilities. Not all of them are developmentally disabled, but sometimes the diagnosis for a developmental disability cannot be made before a child turns 3 years old. These programs have more time to spend with each individual child. The student-to-instructor ratio is lower, and really, the kids who are in these programs can get services that they can't get or won't get in other daycare centers.
Parents will tell you that typical daycare programs, while wonderful for kids, don't know what to do with these kids. They don't have the specialized therapies. They don't have the specialized services.
He feels at home here. It's safe.
This was not done because somebody pointed at this program and said, wow, rampant fraud, inefficiency, we can do better. This was done as just a blanket, hey, you moved from one department to the other, something's got to give, this is gone.
The information the ARC was given is that Department of Children and Families had a $1.8 million gap to fill in their budget, and they decided to axe these programs. All six of them are $1.8 million. Just for perspective, the individual program in Trenton, 28 kids, $385,000.
Could there be in a budget in the future more money to keep the ARC open?
State Senate President Steve Sweeney has told the ARC that he is trying to get that funding into the budget. Let's not forget, Sweeney has a developmentally disabled daughter and has been a leader in this particular field, so we can see if he gets it done.
But Sweeney is a complete hypocrite. I'm sick to my stomach that a guy like Sweeney would even talk about this and pay lip service to this, and clearly it impacts him personally, and I'm not making any judgment on that side. That's his personal life and his own child. What I am saying is, how can you on one hand say, hey, I care about this because it hits my family personally and I'm going to try to help you, and on the other hand, justify spending billions of dollars on projects that would never hit a priority list when you're talking about bridges falling down, et cetera. And I'm talking about the light rails.
Well, the difference is apples and oranges because those projects that you mentioned were bonded, and this is general fund money. You can question his priorities in the general fund, but that's separate from any major project that might happen due to gas tax revenue.
How about the Atlantic City takeover? Great point. I mean, look at the corruption that is rampant. I mean, you got a guy like Steve Sweeney. He and his buddy Chris Christie took over Atlantic City, spent more than $1 million. I mean, there's money that's there, but Jeff Chiesa's got to get his big payday. I wonder how many boats he owns. Chris Christie's got to make sure he lines the friends of his pocket. Hey, maybe not a boat.
But
the point is that these are men living very high on the hog, on taxpayer dollars, and to have a cut like this for one point, I don't want to say it's a small amount of money, but in the grand scheme of $34 billion, this is a drop in the bucket. I think Steve Sweeney should be absolutely ashamed of how he has run this state senate over the past dozen years.
It is a drop in the bucket compared to the state budget, and what I'll say is I did go through the budget, at least a cursory glance at it, and you will see multi-million dollars, tens of millions of dollars going to Cooper programs connected to George Norcross, beneficiary of Steve Sweeney. I wonder if Mr. Norcross could spare us $1.8 million.
Not only that, he could write the check himself for all the money he's made off the taxpayers. But you went through the last budget.
Yes.
Found $700 million.
Yes.
That they could have cut. I mean, maybe you could cut $1.8 million out of the stamp program on, in Trenton.
The fishery study program.
Come on. There
are always going to be sob stories out there. And in terms of the ARC program, absolutely. Nobody wants to see a developmentally challenged child affected. But when it comes to these budget decisions, it's cold. You got to do what you got to do. When Governor Christie cut state funding for Planned Parenthood, he did it and he got reelected. Voters eventually forget about it and they just move on.
You know what?
Nothing's
the disabled kids don't have the same lobbyists that some of these big millionaire companies have.
And kids can't vote, Bill.
Hope Christie, Sweeney, and Chiesa enjoy their weekend with their lavish gifts that they've been passing around each other for the last 10 years.
I hope they get together and do something about this.
Thanks.